Hi and welcome everyone. So on Node.js questions, there can be a question around the event loop and how it works. So the event loop handles all asynchronous callbacks. Okay, so Node.js is a single-threaded event-driven language. That means whenever we are firing these all asynchronous operations, so there should be some way which Node.js is having to deal with all these asynchronous operations together. Because it's a single-threaded, only one asynchronous operations can pass through it. So whenever we are calling http.get, fs.read file or set timeout, Node.js runs these operations and further continue to run the other code without waiting for the output. So we are not waiting for the execution of one asynchronous task. We are just putting that asynchronous task inside the event queue and then going to the next instruction. So all the callback functions are queued into the loop. So this is the event loop where all the callback functions are the asynchronous the calls are queued into inside the event queue. So whenever the operation is getting completed, we are just putting it back. So in the event queue, we will stack all these asynchronous operations. There can be a callback which are dealing with asynchronous operations. So one by one, we will be putting them. And once the network is responding, once we got the response from those APIs, from those calls, from those IO block IO operations, we will be just putting that and then putting that out, and then we are just executing the next blocking operation. So blocking operation is like network operations or a file read write operations. So for that, we are using libuv library is being used to deal with all these operations. Okay. Then other things which we can talk about is the module exports. So in every Node.js files, once we, so module export is just like a, this is a single entity. Whenever we need to export something from one file to another file, then we need to write that code. So module.exports, if I wanted to just I wrote some function, I will define that function on top of it. If I wanted to export this function from this file and I wanted to require it inside another file, then I will be using this module export. So this is actually a single entity which I will be exporting. You can do it for multiple functions. Just wrap them inside an object. So this is the exported object. So there are different ways of doing it. Similarly, you can write other functions. Right. So a module encapsulates related code into a single unit of code. This can be interpreted as a moving all related functions inside a single file. And then finally, you just export it. So like this is greetings.js, okay? So how you will require it in another file? You will do it, something like this. This is ES file. If you are using ESX, then you can use the import export statement. And then you can just call these functions inside another file dot say hello, say hi. Okay.